several topics, we really come from different parties, but we are united on several topics. We have common position on a number of key issues. And the first key issue is immigration. We are not xenophobic, we are not against foreigners. We know the importance of foreigners to the economy. We are just, we are for irresponsible immigration. Not irresponsible one like 1 million workers, foreign workers over 10 years, 100,000 a year. That is irresponsible. So we do not want that. We want a smaller number of that, and which is more, which will not take away jobs from Singaporeans, which will not rob us of our space, in housing, in transport, and which will not take away priority, our places of priority in schools, in jobs, in businesses. And they will not take away our pride. We are foreigners, even so outlandish in their attacks on Singaporeans, and they just despise Singaporeans because this government despises Singaporeans. That is why they are following the government's cue. To despise Singaporeans, you are lazy, you are losers and all that. All the name-calling they have done, that is wrong. They have destroyed our self-esteem. So we must restore our country and take back our country from the government that has sold us out to foreigners. So that is the key topic that we are going to fight for. Then there are issues like CPF. We want CPF to be withdrawn at age 55, back to the original the age that we have started with. We have housing issue. We want it to be truly affordable and not benchmarked to market resale prices. And then we want land cost, land price to be a cost rather than a market price. I mean, market price means which foreigners benchmark, because land price is set by auction to the highest bidder. Okay, with some discount for public housing, but the benchmarking is still by market benchmarking, and you are competing with billionaires for the world. And yeah, and education, the same thing, elitism. They are only concentrating on the top scorers, ignoring the majority of the students. Like 60% of the students do not graduates do not have the skills that employers want. So they are concentrating on the top 10, 15. What's the use of topping the world in maths, in science, when the bulk of the people do not have skills for the economy? So education, housing, transport too. I think transport, as a percentage, we spend about 3.5%, 3.6% of our household income on public transport. That is wrong. That is too high. We should go down to 2.5%, 2 to 2.5% of household income for transport. And that's our proposal in Sing First Social Safety Net. Right? So transport, education, housing, CPF, and immigration. These are the key issues that we are agreeing on.